Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at the MicroPython application for the Flipper Zero. Flipper Zero firmware supports C and JavaScript applications, and the MicroPython application was written in C. It allows you to load a Python script that runs on the Flipper Zero. While the MicroPython app is running, it also adds a PI command to the Flipper Zero command line interface. This PI command allows you to send Python commands to control your Flipper Zero. New features are being added regularly. In this video, I'm covering version 1.5 of MicroPython. Let's get started. Unfortunately, for version 1.5 of MicroPython, I found it often fails to load due to out-of-memory conditions, typically showing bus fault after the crash. I recommend you install the released firmware on your Flipper Zero and launch the released version of the MicroPython application. I've also noticed more success when running a smaller animation. The simplest way to get started is on lab.flipper.net, search for Python, click on the MicroPython app, UPython, and then just click the install button. In QFlipper, click on SD card, then apps_assets, and then UPython. This is where all the samples will be installed. Go ahead and drag and drop your demo Python script. Open apps, and then go to tools, and then choose UPython. If it crashes with a bus fault, go ahead and try it again. Hopefully in a few attempts, the application will load successfully. Later in the video, I'll show you some other techniques to help increase your odds. Go ahead and click OK to open a file. Select our demo.py, and there's our message. Flipper Python, hello world. Our script displays the hello world message, and then it exits 5 seconds later. The documentation for the MicroPython app is really well laid out. Under reference, you'll find all the different features that are supported for the Flipper Zero. For example, if we click on Canvas, you can see all the different functions available for rendering on the canvas. And in some cases, there's even example code. Version 1.5 has features like GPIO and serial port access. Future versions will have features such as NFC, bad USB, and sub-gigahertz. If you're going to develop lots of Python scripts, I recommend setting up a development environment. The prerequisites are the same as my other setup videos, where we use the Get Tools download, the Python download, and the VS Code download. In the MicroPython project, click the Code dropdown, and then click the Copy to Clipboard icon to copy that GitHub URL. In a command prompt, type get clone dash dash recursive and then paste in that URL. Next, type cd space mp-flipper. This is the directory for your MicroPython project. Next, we'll install UFBT. So type python space dash m space pip space install space dash dash upgrade space UFBT. Next, set the index URL to match your firmware. In this video, I'm running the Momentum firmware, so I'll use the Momentum firmware index URL. Next, update your channel to be the release or dev version. I'm running the release version of the firmware. Now we're ready to build and launch the MicroPython app. Type UFBT space compact equals one space debug equals zero space launch. This will build the application and then it will copy it onto your Flipper Zero and launch it. In my case, the Flipper Zero crashed, so we'll go ahead and just run the command again. And this time it succeeded. I've had most success running MicroPython using this technique. If QFlipper is not synchronized with the MicroPython app, go ahead and click OK, and then click the back button until the application shows. And now we're running the latest version of MicroPython. To finish setting up our development environment, type python space dash M space PIP space install space flipper zero. If there's a new version of the package available, you're going to want to do a dash dash upgrade. To demonstrate the upgrade process, I'll go ahead and downgrade us to version 1.3, and then I'll upgrade us to the latest version. Here you can see it successfully uninstalled 1.3 and it installed 1.5. Over in Visual Studio Code, I'll say open folder, and then I'll choose our mp-flipper directory that we created. Next, I'll go ahead and open up the examples folder, and then we can open one of the examples, such as dialog message test. Hovering over a flipper zero function shows us all the information about that function, and we can use the scroll wheel to also see additional information such as what the parameters are used for. When I press Control Space, I get a dropdown with the other function names that match up to the point of my cursor. And this also works for properties such as if I'm on input button, we can see left, back, down, right, etc. If we scroll down in the examples to logger.py, we see a warning about the warn it being deprecated and to use warning instead. This is actually incorrect. This is because the import logging is picking up the system logging package instead of the flipper zero logging package. If anyone knows how to get logging.py and io.py to get picked up for the packages instead of the default system packages, please leave a comment below. Import time is another example where we pick up our system package instead of the MicroPython package. You should generally just use sleep_ms for milliseconds of delay and sleep for seconds of delay. Here's a GPIO example. You can see pin A7 is set for output push-pull, so pulling up to 3.3 or pushing down to ground. Pins PC0 and PC1 are configured as input interrupts when the voltage rises, and they have pull-up resistors applied to them. When PC0 interrupt triggers, we set PA7 to true, turning it on. And when PC1 triggers, we set PA7 to false, turning it off. The app runs for 15 seconds, and then it reinitializes the pins. Let's go ahead and run that demo. So that was flipper0_gpio_interrupt. I have a LED connected to pin A7. And when we connect a wire between ground and C0, that light turns on, and ground and C1, and the light turns off. And again, if you're getting bus faults, I highly recommend you launch the app using the ufpt compact equals 1 debug equals 0 launch command. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, please leave them below or contact me on Discord.